Legend lives on from Chippewa down a big lake they call Gitche. They get said never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. Load of iron ore 26,000 tons more than Edmond Fitzgerald weighed heavy. That good ship and crew was upon the beach when the gales of November come early. Ship was the pride of the American side coming back from Sunmill in Wisconsin. Big freight is gone, it was bigger than most with the crew and good captain well seasoned. Including some turns with a couple of steel fires when they left fully loaded to the river. Later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they can feel it? When in the wires made a tattletale sound and a wave broke over the rail. Every man knew us, the captain did too. T'was the witch of November come stealing. Dawn came late and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. Afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Summertime came, the old cook came on deck saying, fellas, it's too rough to keep you. 7 p.m. in Main Hatchway came in, he said, fellas, it's been good to know y'all. Captain wired and he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. Later in that wind, the lights went out of sight. Can you echo the Edmond Fitzgerald? Anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn in minutes to hours? Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they could 15 more miles behind us. Might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep in tough water. All that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and the bays are the source line. Further below Lake Ontario, takes in one Lake Erie consortium. And the iron boats go as the mariners all know, with the gales in November to December. Yeah. journal is all from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call it Chippewa. Here they say never gives up, the day comes the gales of November come.